Okay, welcome back from the break to this OGC API workshop. We have now a second part in which I will present some practical implementation of OGC APIs using PYGEOAPI. So the first session was more a technical background and the walkthrough of different standards, how these conformance classes are shown there and different the structure, how you can go through the standard. And now we are going this via examples. And the tool, as I said, is PYGEOAPI. This is maybe a little bit of marketing slide saying that install in 5 minutes. It may take even 15 minutes, but to be frank, it's relatively easy to install. The only requirement you should have is to have Python 3 available in first place, and then you can use these Python tools to install the software. In my implementation, I'm using a tool called Anaconda, which is a virtual environment for Python. And if you are installing it using Python 3, I really recommend to create these virtual environments, because when you are installing software or different libraries, when you have this virtual environment, it will not break other environments. So it's a kind of a sandbox and very good point to take into account. And then you can just clone it from GitHub and install. It's using the so-called requirements text. So in that you have all the libraries which will be installed. Then you install and the most important thing is in red rectangle. So the configuration YAML file. So this is really the starting point and what you the only thing you need to do to set up different services is to configure this YAML file. And then in order to run the service, you must set up some environment variables like PYGEOAPI config. So what is the file name for that? The same applies for OpenAPI specification. So it's one YAML file. And then you can run it PYGEOAPI command. I will mute one of the microphones there. Okay. In this case, I'm using Python own web server. It's really recommended to use Apache or some other web service in production. So this is mainly for demonstration purposes. And then I can use it in my local host. I have changed my port to 8080, but by default it's port 5000. If we have a look into metadata of the service, kind of the basic structure and the basic metadata for the service, you first have some identification information, like in this case, GOE3 API, some description, keywords, potential links, contact names, etc. So these are just generic information for this service. It doesn't go into the details of the actual data yet. So this is common for the whole landing page of PYGEOAPI. In my case, I made a bat file. I'm in Windows environment. It could be a shell script, but how to start this? So to setting these configurations and then this PYGEOAPI serve, and it will open the service. And what we have in first place, this is the generic metadata. So as I described, the title, GOE3 API, description, keywords, and then provider information on the right-hand side. So my name there and some contact information. So this is read dynamically or directly from this YAML file. And then we will have these different collections and processes, API definitions, conformance, and other information available in the service as well. And like Joanna mentioned, in OGC API standards, there are no required encodings, but recommendations are usually to have HTML and then JSON as well. And like you can see from the screen right now, we have this landing page in HTML. But if I just change it to JSON, I have more or less the same information available as machine readable information. But of course, for humans, the previous page was a bit more fun to read, but this actually showing same information, but in JSON. I did using in this screenshot Firefox, so it has a little bit of different visualization of JSON. In Chrome, it's really boring, so I have Firefox in my machine.